Hi, I'm Julie Goodnight, and I'm here to tell you about an important all-purpose training tool, the flag. Some variation of the training flag has been employed for centuries in horsemanship, but has become more prevalent recently with the popularity of natural horsemanship. Natural horsemanship is simply knowing and understanding the horse's natural behavior and then using that information to relate to him in a way that he can understand. The training flag can be used in a variety of different settings, both in horse training and in everyday use around the barn. Here are some specific uses for the flag. We can use it in groundwork, such as round pin work or lead line work. We'll use it in starting horses under saddle for the very first time. We'll use it in trailer loading, and then in just general barn and paddock safety every day. We'll also use it as a really valuable tool in desensitizing and despooking horses. In this video series, we're going to take a look, first of all, at the safe and effective use of this training tool, and I'll show you some specific training techniques and explain some really important concepts in horse behavior and natural horsemanship that will make the training flag an invaluable tool. So let's get started. As with any endeavor in horses, safety is of the absolute utmost importance. There's a few things that you need to know to use the flag safely and effectively. First of all, the first time you present a flag to a horse, he may have an extremely reactive response. It's hard to say. Every horse is going to be totally different in the way he responds to the flag. Some horses won't respond at all. This horse has seen a flag quite a bit. It's totally unimportant to her. But another horse might react violently the first time you use it. So we want to just keep that in mind and be prepared for an extreme reaction. If the horse does react in an extreme manner to the flag, just remember to keep your motions smaller, keep the flag down lower, and at any time you need to, at any time you have an issue of whether or not you're in control of your horse, just simply drop the flag so that it's out of the picture and you don't have to worry about it. Also, it's important to remember never strap a flag or whip or anything like that to your body or to the horse if the horse is not used to the flag. We always want to be able to drop it on a moment's notice in case the horse overreacts. So don't strap it to your body or tie it on in any way. Also, another really important component for safety in anything with horses is to really know and understand the horse's behavior, where his behavior comes from, what he's capable of, and know and understand the movements of the horse, where the danger zones are. We're going to show you that later on in this series, but if I can always keep an awareness of the horse's movements, the directions he can move, and the defensive actions he might take, then I can keep myself in a safe place. What's the purpose of the flag, you might ask? Well, it has a number of important uses. For one thing, it can be an extension of your arm. And so there are many instances when I might want to gesture to the horse or point him in a certain direction, but I don't want to get so close to him that I could touch him. So I can use the flag as an extension of my arm. In other words, when I point to the horse like this, I'm going to use the exact same motion with the flag, and pretty soon he'll learn that hand motion. Also, the flag will defend and define my space. And so my space is generally as far as I can reach all the way around me. And I'm going to use that flag to define my space to the horse and to defend my space. If he moves into, encroaches on my space a little bit too much, I can use the flag to back him up. Also, we'll use the flag in order to apply an aversive stimuli to the horse. If I have an unresponsive horse, a horse that won't move when I ask him to, or he won't react to any of my cues, I can use the flag as an aversive or obnoxious stimuli to reinforce what it is that I'm asking the horse to do. Finally, a really important use for the flag is in desensitizing a horse to scary stimuli. And we'll show you a little bit later some important techniques for desensitizing the horse and how we're going to use the flag to get the horse started in becoming less sensitive to novel stimuli, and also teach him to just stand quietly, accept what's going on around him, and be a little bit less spooky. You might ask yourself, why does the horse respond to the flag? Why does it work? Well, for a number of reasons. The flag offers many different types of stimuli to the horse. There is an auditory component, so I can make a loud noise. There's a visual component when the flag moves and shakes and changes shape. Also, there's a tactile stimuli. I can use the flag on the horse's body to get him used to feels and sensations and places maybe that he's not normally used to being touched. So there's a lot of different stimuli there. Also, the flag gives us mental pressure in addition to physical pressure. So most of the time when we talk about the training of horses, we talk a lot about applying physical pressure to the horse. We squeeze with our legs when we want him to go. We pull back on the reins when we want him to stop. Those are all examples of physical pressure. But mental pressure is something very real to the horse. In fact, he may feel it more even than physical pressure sometimes. And so the fact that the flag makes a sound, it makes a strange movement, it is somewhat to the horse unpredictable, all of that gives us a way to use the flag to put mental pressure on the horse as well as physical. The fact that the flag tends to change shape from the horse's visual point of view, he doesn't really understand if it's something that's alive or not. And so the flag will have a tendency to possibly trigger the horse's flight response, to trigger his prey mentality, because it's something that he can't quite define the shape of it. It's moving. It has some qualities that make him a little bit suspicious. And all of that helps us put a little bit more mental and physical pressure on the horse. There's lots of different types of flags that you can use. To me, it's really important that the flag is lightweight and balanced in your hand. I have rather small hands, so it's important to me that the flag has a good feel. It's easy for me to hold. It's easy for me to gesture. Also, it's important that the attachment of the flag is secure. It's not going to come off when you're using it. So this flag has a very secure, tight, kind of a high-tech connection here. And it should just be comfortable and easy for you to hold. The flag is a much more effective tool for doing this type of work with the horse, groundwork, and for communicating and gesturing with the horse, because it's easy to make small, subtle movements. I don't particularly care for using a whip or a stick around the horse because they're too clunky and awkward to use. I want to be able to use the flag in very subtle and articulate gestures with the horse. Another quality that's important in the flag that you use is that it's rigid. And I would like to be able to poke the horse if I need to. If I need to defend my space, move the horse out of my space, I need it to be just a little bit rigid for that purpose. So there's a couple of primary purposes that we're going to use the flag for. One is as a motivator, and that's going to be in order to put pressure on the horse, either mental or physical. And I'll explain that a little bit more in just a minute. The second area in which we're going to use the flag is in desensitizing of the horse and getting him used to novel stimuli. But first, let's talk a little bit about using the flag as a motivator to change the horse's behavior. Now, first of all, you need to understand that whenever you wish to change a horse's behavior, you have to apply enough pressure on him to motivate him to change. And how much pressure you use is totally dependent on the individual horse. But however my horse is acting right now is the way she's most motivated to act. So if I wish to influence her behavior, I have to put enough pressure on her to motivate her to change. What horses want more than anything else in life is comfort and security. And so we're going to use the flag. When we use the flag as an aversive stimuli, what we're going to do is apply pressure when the horse is doing the wrong thing and then release the pressure when the horse is doing the right thing. And that's what we call negative reinforcement. Most of the training that we do with horses is negative reinforcement. And what that means is that we apply an aversive or an obnoxious stimuli to the horse, and then when the horse responds correctly, we take away the stimuli. And so that is where the negativity comes in. It's by taking away the pressure. And so, for instance, when I train the horse to go, I put my legs on him, and that's an aversive stimuli. And when the horse begins to move, I take the pressure of my legs away. And so the horse is rewarded for the correct response. So when we use the flag as an aversive stimuli, we're going to flag the horse, use the flag, shake the flag, put it in his space until the horse does what we want him to do. As soon as he gets the right answer and he does what we want him to do, we're going to take away the stimuli. And that's what we call in natural horsemanship, making the right thing easy and the wrong thing hard. So a couple of examples of when you might use the flag as an aversive stimuli, we're going to show you later in this series. But one example might be if you have a lazy, unresponsive horse that is refusing to respond to your directives. Let's say I'm asking this horse to trot and he's just totally ignoring me. I can use the flag in that instance and I'll flag the horse until he obeys, and then I'll release the flag. Another example of when we might use the flag as an aversive stimuli to encourage the horse to do the correct thing is when it comes to trailer loading. And we're going to show you this a little bit later. And we want the horse to learn that when he does what we ask him to, which is to walk forward and get in the trailer, nothing's going to bother him. But if he disobeys and doesn't do what we ask him to, that flag is going to come out and it's going to be an obnoxious stimuli to him. So he'll learn to do what we ask in order to avoid the aversive stimuli. The second area in which we're going to use the flag is in the desensitizing of a horse and despooking. This horse has already been desensitized to the flag, so no matter what I do with it, she's not going to respond. She's not going to try to run off or do any of those things. And she didn't get that way just by accident. She got that way from somebody working with her with a flag to teach her that sometimes there's scary things in this world, but I'll take care of you, and if you'll just stand there and accept that scary stimuli, it'll go away. So we're going to use the flag for desensitization with a technique called advance and retreat. And I'll explain that technique to you later on in this series. But basically, you know, by nature, horses tend to be impulsive and reactive. They are act first, think later animals. And that's what we know of as the flight response. And so what we're going to teach the horse through these desensitization techniques is to think first and don't act at all. And that's not always an easy thing to do, but with the use of the flag and with the techniques called advance and retreat, we can pretty much teach any horse to accept scary and novel stimuli. So what we'll do is we'll use the flag initially to teach the horse that he can accept the scary stimuli, and then that information will transfer into other scary stimuli like the water hose or fly spray or using the clippers on the horse. We're also going to use the flag to desensitize the horse to movement over his head, movement all around him, movement between his legs and around his feet. And this is going to be really important, particularly if you're trying to prepare a horse for trail riding, where we want him to be less sensitive to his environment.